Phone lines are open. Their phones haven't stopped coming since 9:45 this evening. R.K. Mishra of the Nabara Democratic Party, but as a citizen tonight, Bijan Mishra, consumer expert, Ashwini Kakkar, CEO of Mercury Travels, Jitendra Bhargav with me, former executive director of Air India, C.R. Kesavan of the Congress Party, R.V. Sujay Krishna Rangarao of the YSR Congress. My first question is to you, and you are joining us from Hyderabad tonight. Mr. R.V. Sujay Krishna Rangarao, would you like to apologize on behalf of your party and your party MP and voluntarily, on your own, just ask this member of parliament to go to the closest police station and put himself in lockup? That is the only option. That is the only option, because if someone's...
No.
You know, one second. Why don't you just put this man in lockup? He does not deserve to be a member of parliament, does he? Jitendra Bhargav, does he?
Absolutely not. Behavior is absolutely deplorable.
Yeah, behavior is deplorable. Ashwini Kakkar, he has shown a level of arrogance that is unacceptable in any modern democracy.
Absolutely. Ashwini Kakkar. In modern society, in any democracy, This is completely unacceptable. And in developed countries, in civilized countries, I think, you know, any person, whether it's a VIP or any other person, if he takes any action or if he does anything to vandalize public property or to threaten, even threaten, forget about taking assault action, then he is straight away put behind bars.
You see,
whether it's railways, whether it's airlines, whether it's bus services, anything.
Actually, let everyone speak before the representative of the YSR Congress. You know, my question tonight is, which democracy in the world do we see so-called representatives fight for themselves being placed at a higher pedestal than the people? But this is disappointing. I am disappointed in the civil aviation minister of the Narendra Modi government. I'm seriously disappointed, because he says law will take its own course. What law? Bijan Mishra, in which course? And this government got elected. This government got elected saying that we will end VVIP racism. Before the elections, when we would report cases like this, the same BJP would come and say, we will end it. No Lal Batti culture after we come in. Today is a test for the Modi government to force action. The civil aviation minister should force a case that the Air India files an FIR against this particular individual. But I've seen no action from anyone in this government.
Even Air India as an organization should take up this case on behalf of its employees. Why should the poor single employee fight? There is a very strong section 353. Section 353 is very clear.
The citizens.
But you see, if Air India is going to legitimize Gundaism, Bijan Mishra, then let it say so. I think Air India should send a letter to all its employees. Dear Air India employee, please prepare to get assaulted. Air India won't back you. Please prepare to get slapped. The government will do nothing for you. It is part of your... Bijan Mishra, I'm serious. The Air India and the Civil Aviation Ministry should say that you are henceforth a slave of every member of parliament who can treat you with whatever disrespect they want. They can slap you, they can physically assault you. We will do nothing for you, each for your own.
And they can come at any time.
No, I'm not being unfair.
They can board the aircraft at any time.
But all I'm doing is,
and the passengers need to tolerate all these things.
Okay, Bijan Mishra.
Rather than make an employee file,
you see, Bijan Mishra. Bijan Mishra.
Any external kind of threats to him.
No, one second. Bijan Mishra.
Arnab, it's a slap on the face of the citizens.
Yeah.
That MP has slapped a citizen. He has undermined an employee. Absolutely. He doesn't have a right. You know, he can't force himself. He comes late. And then he shouts at the, you know, station manager that he should board the aircraft irrespective of he coming late. Then where is the discipline? That's why Air India is deteriorating every day. You know, the morale has gone down. There is no motivation to the employee.
I'll tell you one thing.
Functioning of Air India.
I'll tell you one thing. Mr. Sujay Krishna Rangarao, let me get a point. Your point of view on this. I say that Mr. Rangarao, see, a government official, an airport manager of Air India, gets slapped by your member of parliament. Slapped, you know, assaulted. And after that, there's open gundaism by gundas from your party. Gundas of the YSR Congress, who, like gundas do, they walk in, they brutalize, they beat up the airport manager, they thrash him without identification. I mean, they carry out action which is, I would call, an action of political terrorism. Now tell me, Mr. R.V. Sujay Krishna Rangarao, why should we tolerate these political terrorists? this political terrorist from your party.
No, we did not.
This political terrorist from your party.
We did not tolerate.
So why don't you take action? What action have you taken against him?
We need not tolerate political terrorists, but before coming to a conclusion that a certain MP is a political terrorist, we need to know the facts.
I have all the facts with me. What facts are you talking about? No, what facts are you talking about?
Officer.
Two relatives, 1 minute.
Pardon?
What facts? You want to confound people? You can't confound people.
Yep.
Two relatives of a member of parliament from Andhra Pradesh's Rajapet constituency were scheduled to be on the flight,
people.
Listen to me, from Tirupati to New Delhi, decide to stroll in 20 minutes before the flight. Flight is to take off. They are armed. They are refused boarding passes by an honest and diligent Air India officer because the honest officer cannot allow a member of parliament's relatives to walk in 20 minutes before takeoff. What facts are you talking about? I have the facts with me. What facts do you have?
I agree.
No, you agree means you
after
sack
this
the guy.
Incident occurred.
What do you mean
he's
you
a
agree?
Party colleague of mine.
Pardon
me? Let me speak. Let me speak. After this incident occurred and it has been reported in the media, since he is my party colleague, I spoke to him. And he denied it outright.
No, he denied. You accept him to accept.
Anybody.
No, what do you mean? He gives himself a clean chit. What kind of logic is that? What kind of logic is that? Please listen to me. I'll tell you the facts. He was told that the boarding gate is closed by the Air India representative. He says, today the argument that I'm being given by the YSR Congress representative is the man has given himself a clean chit. R.K. Mishra, the man has given himself a clean chit, so why are you asking questions? R.K. Mishra, this is the kind of absurd logic that we have to hear on national television. I'm really going to open. I think I have so many
don't
calls.
Do expect,
R.K. Mishra.
No, that's
R.K. Mishra.
No,
R.K. Mishra.
Do you expect anything better than from a political exposed person? In fact, first he came and he said, we are really sorry and we apologize. I thought, maybe you are talking to somebody who is not a politician. Now I know very clearly that he is a politician. What is the other side of the story? First, your man comes late. Second, he is asked not to board. Not only that, he is not allowed to board. He goes, threatens and beats people. What nonsense you are talking about? It is the chairman of Air India. He has guts, fortunately, to tell employees, don't allow any such VIPs to board. Now, Air India Association and unions go for a strike for drop of a hat. Why the hell they are not going and filing a police complaint against
you? No democracy in the world do we see representatives of the people, so-called people, get violently upset when the people gently remind them that rules will not be broken because they belong to some ill-conceived VVIP class. He insulted, ridiculed and literally beat the hell out of the honest work ethic of a government employee. This man should not be allowed into parliament. Somebody will say, let's not upset Jagan Mohan.
Sumitra Mahajan.
Let's not upset Jagan Mohan. He may be an ally in the future. He should not be allowed into viewers. Do you believe this man should not be allowed into parliament, Mr. Kesavan? Mr. Kesavan. Mr. Kesavan, now please, Mr. Kesavan.
Public employee.
Mr. Kesavan.
Arnab, you've been a crusader against VIP racism, transcending parties. I mean, you had incidents with the Congress party, BJP and everybody. As far as this incident is concerned, please let me make my points uninterrupted. This is not just condemnable, it is unpardonable and inexcusable, Arnab. This is a clear abuse of, rank abuse of power and position. And I just wanted to raise one point with you. See, we see what happened with Mr. Devendra Fadnavis delaying an international flight. That was with Air India. Then you saw how Kiran Rijiju offloaded three passengers when he and, Deputy Chief Minister of CM had to take an Air India flight. See, the problem here, right, you rightly said, it's with the national carrier. And these people behave, especially MPs and MLAs in political class, behave like they are, feudal lords with a feudal mindset where they think they can intimidate, browbeat, bully, bulldoze.
Yeah.
Whether these government officials go to the line and they treat Air India like a private fiefdom and a personal playground. I will really just, I think you mentioned many times, Arnab, that wanted a legislation. Let me just make one thing clear. This Air India is run by taxpayers' money. Like somebody rightly said, this is a slap on every citizen of India. All of us are paying money and that is the, and that's how Air India is run. If this government means business, I think the first thing they should do is send a circular to Air India. What is the crux of the problem, Arnab? The official, in fact, took a whole day to file a complaint. He's worried because the political people can use their connection and transfer him. They didn't even kick him out of a job.
No, it's absurd. Mr. Kesavan.
Why don't we have a circular?
Mr. Kesavan.
Circular with Air India. Very clear from the Civil Aviation Ministry saying that, you know, this applies to everybody and these
you
people
see,
can't
you
go
see,
in these.
Mr. Kesavan. Mr. Kesavan, I agree with you. On most occasions, I disagree with you. Tonight, I thoroughly, totally, 100% agree with you. In this case, you are correct. The airline asks the employee, go file a complaint against a member
That's
of parliament. So basically, you are telling the employee that, you know,
you are on your own.
Yeah. Right? That's the point. You are on your own. You are on your own. Yeah. Go fight your own battles. And especially when the minister, what's his name? The person who thinks he's royalty and goes around taking cigarette packets and proudly says, I smoke inside planes. Well, Gajapati Raju says, like a broken record, the civil aviation minister says, law will take its own course. Mr. Gajapati Raju, if this were to happen to somebody you knew, if this airport official was your relative, would you say, Mr. Civil Aviation Minister, law will take its own course? And then you tell, when the Civil Aviation Minister is siding with this gunda, you tell the employee, if you want to fight, take up the case on your own. I'm telling you, Mr. Kesavan, if today there is any reason this case is, there's an FIR, it is only and only and only because the media has made it a big issue. Because otherwise, nobody would give a damn about
what... The media should be appreciated and also the official...
Absolutely.
The media should be appreciated, Arnab, and the official should also be like congratulated for summing up.
Mr. Rangarao, let me tell you one thing. Go tell this fellow, Mithun or whatever his name
Reddy.
Is. Mithun Reddy. This good-for-nothing gunda party MP of yours. Go tell him that he's not going to be allowed to get away with it. Go tell him that. And tell him, apologize, go personally to the Air India manager, say I'm sorry. Right? Change your tactics. Otherwise, you cannot be allowed to represent the people and then do this to the people. That is the least, Mr. Rangarao, that your member of parliament should do on his own. I'd now like to get in and not threaten him. Mr. Sarvanan of the DMK, please. Mr. Sarvanan of the DMK, please. Yeah.
Can I just make a point?
I think the leader of the YSR Congress party should step in. I think this is not doing any good to the party, which is, you know, I think you should ask him to at least make an apology to begin with. First, make an apology, then the organization as such should be behind these. The official and an FIR has to be lodged. It is very, very deplorable that an FIR has not even been lodged. This kind of behavior is totally unacceptable even from a common
MP.
This is totally unacceptable.
Joining us from the railway station at Hyderabad is Subba Reddy, his chief whip and member of parliament in the Lok Sabha of the YSR Congress. He has a train to catch about half an hour from now. I will not delay him because we want him to reach on time and not break any rules to try and reach the... You never know how members of parliament... No, Mr. Subba Rao, don't take it personally. But the fact of the matter is, do you really expect this fellow Mithun to get away? Having slapped an airport manager, do you expect him to get away?
No, Mr. Arnab. Everybody has to abide by the law.
Why not him?
See, whatever has happened according to our MP, he has not slapped the...
No, the MP will not accept. No, MP, you can't place the MP's, clean chit to himself as no value.
Now, when as a defaulter, you admitted.
Jitendra,
defaulter or...
There are witnesses, sir. There are witnesses.
Ever admit.
Look, there are witnesses who will stand up in court and say that we have seen it. Then?
I think you are being naive to believe that if the man... The MP concerned will admit it. He's not going to do it.
Yeah. So, Mr. Subba Rao, that what your MP says has no value.
And what is the reason for you to distrust the Air India employee?
Okay,
person?
Mr. Subba Rao.
He's got no axe to grind.
He has only requested airlines official to allow the passengers, about 10 to 15 passengers were there, in which his cousin and his auntie were also there. That's why he has requested airlines official to take them on board.
No, there's no question.
Slapping is not requesting. Slapping and requesting are two different ends of the spectrum, sir.
He has not slapped.
Of course he has slapped.
He has not slapped.
One second. He has slapped. It is on record. On what basis are you saying that he hasn't? Okay, let's pit our facts against yours. There's a criminal case which has been registered against him. Don't you know about it under sections 323, 353, 448 of the Indian Penal Code?
I know, Mr. Arnab. I know what I mean to say is,
yes,
it is not there on the record. If it is record, it
sir,
is
don't try and confuse people. It won't happen. No, no, Mr. Subbarao, let me remind you. Yes. You are the same person, if I am not mistaken.
Yeah.
On the 16th of July, 2015, yeah, you came on this program after the Rajahmundry tragedy where people had died.
Yes.
You remember that tragedy? And you remember why that tragedy happened? Because there was a VVIP racism that was going on at the Ghat. You said on that day that because of this VVIP racism, common men were inconvenienced and the tragedy happened. What happens now?
Yes.
When your party MP does the same thing, you change your line.
Now he wants to believe his party MP. He wants to believe his party MP. What a shame. Our MP has not slapped the airline
subject.
If it is there in CC camera footage, let law will take court.
One second. Mr. Subbarao, you cannot, first of all, who are these people who behave like that, and then leaders like you are remorselessly coming on television and saying the slap did not happen. Let me remind you that in a phone conversation with our reporter, the Tirupati airport station manager, on being asked what was the basic complaint against this gunda called Mithun Reddy, said, quote, there was a 15 passenger no show on yesterday's flight who happened to be a relative of MP. So he demanded that they be accepted. So we said no. I think anybody who assaults a government officer on duty is a gunda. I think anybody who assaults a government officer on duty is a gunda. What investigation? Are you saying the airport authorities are lying? Are you saying the airport authorities are lying, Mr. Subbarao? Only Mr. Subbarao and me, please. Mr. Subbarao. Mr. Subbarao, please, only Mr. Subbarao. Mr. Subbarao, listen to me.
Civil Aviation Minister, Air India comes under Civil Aviation Minister.
Mr. Subbarao, listen to me. The Tirupati station manager, Rajaram, please listen to me. Have the patience to listen. Don't display your arrogance on television. Don't try that with me. Mr. Subbarao, listen to me. I'm telling you, anybody who does what this character Mithun did is a gunda. And I would say it again and again. Somebody who assaults a government officer on duty for doing his job, physically assaults him, is a gunda. I would say so. And Mr. Subbarao, the Tirupati station manager, what do you mean no?
You should not.
What, Mr. Subbarao, will you listen to me? Will you listen to me?
Yeah,
or will you carry on non-stop?
Yeah.
Mr. Subbarao, the Tirupati station manager, Rajaram, even confirmed to our channel in the conversation that not only did this fellow, Mithun, hit a station manager, but his supporters who were present inside the airport premises were part of the roughing up of the airport manager. The station manager also said there were 15 people associated with the MP who roughed up the airline manager. And this is on record. Mr. Rajaram has also said that the Tirupati Airport Authority has submitted a complaint with the closed circuit television recording investigations are on. If this proof does not stand to validate,
53. He
has to be in jail. He has to be in jail.
No. First of all,
I have an airport manager from.
If he is found guilty, let him.
1 minute, Arjun is calling. He works at the airport in New Delhi. Arjun, our first caller tonight on Tirupati Slapgate. Arjun, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Go ahead, Arjun. Identify yourself. What are you saying, please?
My only question is, after going through the whole episode, is to the airport, the aviation minister of this country, where he just said the law would take its own course.
Yeah.
I mean, the position which he's holding of such a democracy, he would should have been more assertive in saying more than the law would own course. He should have said very assertively in a stern way that if that has happened, he should be put behind bars. That invokes sort of more trust with his own employees in the aviation sector, not only Air India,
you know,
but all the airlines to behave as per the job, what requires them to be, because considering what the state of affairs at the moment, which is happening.
I completely agree with you. Arjun, hear this. Let's go to Virendra Thakur, who's calling in from Hyderabad today. And I'm making one point tonight, that this man who behaves like royalty, the civil aviation minister, what's his name? Gajapati Raju. He should know that the commercial director of Air India, Pankaj Srivastav, the commercial director of Air India, Pankaj Srivastav, has also confirmed manhandling of the staff officer. Now the real story is this, that the minister must behave, ask himself whether he wants to support the citizen or support members of the spoiled political class of India. If the civil aviation minister
His
duties to his employees.
Absolutely.
His duties to his employees.
Absolutely.
Mr. Kesavan.
Of courage.
Yeah.
What has happened is this official was doing his duty in the security hold area, and he was summoned, you know, when he was supervising flight preparedness, he was summoned by this MP, verbally abused and slapped. Let me ask you a fundamental logical question, Arnab. This government official has summed up courage to file a criminal complaint against a member of parliament.
Hats
and he knows there is a camera there. If the camera is going to show otherwise, if the camera is going to say that the MP is not in fault, why will he file a criminal complaint? This clearly shows the official knows there is a camera, and the official is convinced that the MP has slapped him, which is why he's filed a complaint, and the truth is going set him free when the video camera will reveal how the MP has behaved.
What is this logic, Mr. Kesavan, where my aunt, nephew, uncle, mamaji, father, sister, mother, brother, anyone is traveling, and hence 20 minutes before the aircraft I can walk in. Don't sack this member of parliament means you're calling for a reversal of democracy, from MPs being the servers of the people to people being the slaves of the people they put in parliament. And I think I have an ex-caller, Virendra Thakur from Hyderabad. Virendra Thakur, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Hi, good evening. Go ahead.
Very good evening, Arnab, and thanks for the opportunity for giving me.
Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, the only question I have in my mind going by this episode is that if suppose a common traveler of any fleet of Air India, for matter any flight,
right,
if he or she does the same thing, what Mr. MP has done, he or she will be allowed to go by the flight or to his or her home respectfully without any, law being affecting to him or her?
Absolutely not. Relevant point, please. Mr. Subbarao, you're the chief whip of the YSR Congress. In other words, you're also the man responsible for the discipline of members of your party. You need to listen to these people tonight, right? Listen to Satish. Satish, what would you say to Mr. Subbarao? Satish from Hyderabad, go on. Satish.
Right. Again, investigation, court, trial, everything takes hell lot of time. But immediate action. Can speaker take any action? Can party take any action? And can court take it as a sumato? Immediate action.
Yeah.
Message has to go. He is representing several lakhs of people.
Yeah.
So immediate action is needed, and this should be a lesson. This kind of
I think, as you mentioned,
political terrorism.
I'm telling you, this is nothing but political terrorism. Satish, I'm just coming back to you. You see, there are 14,87,498 people in the electorate of Rajampet. This is a slap in the face that this political terrorist has slapped 14,87,498 people in Rajampet on their face. And no, Mr. Subbarao, throw him out. Mr. Subbarao, throw him out. His defense has no value.
Definitely investigation proves that he has slapped it.
No, what investigation?
Any CC camera footage is there.
What?
Let them produce. Definitely party will take.
Oh, so you're saying the onus is on the person who's been slapped to prove that he's been slapped. The onus is not on the person who's slapped.
There is evidence. There is evidence.
Bijan Mishra to Subbarao.
The advisory gives 45 minutes prior to departure. They are supposed to take the boarding pass. Half an hour before departure, they are supposed to report to the gate. So there is evidence that they have violated the advisory They have reported late. So it is enough to take action that how dare they threatened the staff
in terms
of reporting late and not taking reprimanded by the party.
Mr. Subba Rao,
you see, law will take its turn. What do you mean by that?
What law will take its turn? Absolutely no value. Mr. Subba Rao,
you must bring discipline to the MPs. You must tell the MPs that they have to behave like normal citizens.
Yeah, you know
they
what?
Can't behave like VVIPs.
Yeah,
they are elected representatives. They are servants of the people.
Yeah.
They are paid salary by us. It is our money which goes to them.
Absolutely. Let Subba Rao speak.
They cannot undermine the passengers nor the employees of the airline.
Yeah,
that airline belongs to us. That airline doesn't belong to the MP.
They will not fly like a common man, because if he was a common man or behaved like a common man, he would have been put behind bars for this behavior.
In the present context, the MPs have to behave now.
Subba Rao.
Those days are gone.
Subba Rao, tell me one thing. I want to ask you a basic question.
Yeah.
Subba Rao, this fellow, what's his name? Mithun, this political terrorist Mithun. If Mithun must have traveled outside India, but now let me complete. It's my view. Anybody who behaves in a culture with reeks of the culture of entitlement and boorishness in a democratic country is a political terrorist. So don't mind my saying that he's a political terrorist. Now my question is this:
he has to be punished.
Mr. Subba Rao, tell me one thing, Mr. Subba Rao. If Mithun goes to Heathrow Airport, and he's catching a British Airways flight, and he lands up 15 minutes before, and the airline officials stop him, will Mithun starts getting his other gundas with him and start slapping people at Heathrow Airport also? How come these same politicians behave well when they're outside the country? But in our own country.
Behind bars.
No, you tell me which MP from India would behave like this. And if this had happened in Heathrow Airport, let me tell you, the man would have been in lockup for at least 1 year. So tell me.
No, Mr. Andab, here he is not traveling. He has only requested.
Oh, so you. Okay, so suppose.
Who is traveling? First of all, the time
next
of the 200 people who are sitting on the plane is less valuable than the time of this one person. They also have flights at the other end to connect to. They want to catch. There are sick people on the flight. There are other people on the flight. I must tell all the viewers that there are at least 10 agencies, independent agencies, who become active in the last 1 hour of the flight, which have nothing to do with one another. There are the luggage people, there is the ground handling, there are people who are catering, there are police security, there is a hold area and boarding team, there is pilot and his team, tractor and push off, cargo and luggage, air traffic control and tractor teams, all kinds of people, like all different teams, and that is why that 45 minutes is required. And otherwise the safety and security of every passenger is compromised. And these rules are there to be followed.
By the way, Mr. Subba Rao, this airport official, a manager, is not your paid servant, he's not your slave, he's not a member of a lower class, he's not undeserving, and you are not his patron. So I hope, one second, Mr. Subba Rao, I let you go because I don't want you. I don't want you to be late for your train and delay the train. So I let you go, Mr. Subba Rao. Thank you very much. Just sack this man, please.
Arnab,
as soon as that you can. Yes, please.
Arnab, I would like to speak.
Wait, well, I'll come to you, sir. Let's get the next caller and 1 minute. I'm coming to you, Mr. Ranga Rao. Colonel Ramesh, an ex-serviceman, is calling in from Hyderabad tonight. Colonel Ramesh, good evening. Good evening, Colonel.
Good evening, Arnab.
Good evening. How are you, sir?
It's nice talking to you.
Same here, sir. Very much.
I have got only 2 points.
Sir.
What was CISF is doing when this man has been slapped? That MP would have been put in jail there.
I agree with you.
Why they have waited?
Yeah.
Why they have waited? CAF doesn't allow us also do anything illegal there.
Good point. I think R.K. Mishra, you agree with that? R.K. Mishra, I think he has a strong point there. What was the CISF doing? Was this matter
Absolutely.
Brought to the attention?
I was just trying to understand if this man... No. If this man is not traveling, he is trying to push his uncle, auntie, moza, mozi. What was the CISF doing? By the way, CISF job is, if he is a gunda and if he is also political terrorist, he should not be allowed to enter. How was he allowed to do it? Not only
I
him,
think I don't know what
friends are allowed to go
no,
and
no,
meet
no, 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 he is a dangerous.
This is a serious breach of integrity.
No, why, exactly.
By the way, our civil aviation minister. Civil aviation minister should know he is jeopardizing the security of all other passengers.
No,
what CISF is doing? Why is he?
I have so many callers tonight. Nikhil is calling from Palampur. Mr. Rangara, I am coming to you after that. From Gujarat, Palampur, Nikhil is an educationist. Yes, Nikhil. Good evening. Good evening, Nikhil.
Good evening. Good evening, Arnab. I was waiting for talking to you since the last 1 year.
Thank you. It's good to speak to you, Nikhil.
Yeah, and I'm not happy with the point of this VVIP racism, you know, today. The problem is, you know, I'm very much sad and weakened by the, you know, democracy, what we are, democratic freedom, what we are having right now. But the VVIPs are using it, misusing it, you know, completely. Now, I was just wondering, if I was the person who did this, they could have jailed me, the CISF or whatever.
You're right.
Government officials, they could have
immediately
hooked me or whatever they could have done, you know, in the best possible manner they could have done it.
Yes.
But as per the last caller, I'm so much agreeing that these MPs are so strong that they have so much political backup. One was just waiting for the call and you just asked him to, yeah, you can go onto the train. One person was backing from that side, another person, I don't know his name. He looked very cool that my MP was perfect and fine.
Yeah.
All are backing. Who will back us? There is nobody. I am so much afraid that today there is nobody who can back us.
I
if Kovan wants to speak as something against Jayalalitha,
well, you know, Nikhil,
he is not. He will be caught
Nikhil,
up.
Yeah. Nikhil.
Yeah.
Nikhil.
Yeah.
The media and citizenry working together can make a big change. And I think there are people out there who need to put that change. I'm telling you, Nikhil, I said it today. It's not like we are self. We have the ability to push and ensure accountability. Yeah. You're absolutely right. Any common citizen touches an airport official or a government official or anyone doing their job at an airport, they'd be jailed immediately, no questions asked. Now, Mr. Rangarao. Mr. Rangarao, please tell me, if there was an election tomorrow, you'd take action against him, right? Now, there's no election. Election is 3 years away. Who cares?
No,
right? People will forget.
Whether there is election or not, there needs to be conclusive proof.
What
it has been alleged by an officer that he has been slapped. Yeah.
No, what conclusive proof?
There has been
there
an allegation
there is,
that an
there
officer
is an on-record. You think
the concerned MP says?
No. Mr. Sarvanan.
No, excuse me.
Mr. Sarvanan, conclusive proof.
The concerned MP says that he has not slapped.
No. It doesn't matter what he says. It's like saying Suresh Kalmadi says I have no role in the CWG scam. Would you believe Suresh Kalmadi?
No.
Mr. Sarvanan.
No, I won't believe.
Then why would you
believe? It has to be
Mr. Sarvanan.
Conclusive end.
No, Mr. Sarvanan. Mr. Sarvanan.
Whether there is conclusive proof or not at this moment, what they owe is an apology and, you know, an immediate, you know, at least some semblance that, you know, the democracy is at work, the rule of law is at work. This is totally ridiculous that nothing is happening.
No.
So far, nothing has happened.
It's unfortunate.
Very, very unfortunate, as pointed out by Mr. K. So very unfortunate.
We need to know why he is in the airport in the first place.
No speck of dust is even
exactly.
Thank you for telling
us. We need to know why Mr. Mithun Reddy was in the airport at that time.
His
family was not there.
He should not have been
at the airport.
Come to drop his relatives in the airport.
Yeah, but not
he was in the airport. He came by the incoming flight. He was in the airport because he was coming in the incoming flight. He arrived by
that
flight.
No, not to force his way.
He was in the airport.
Not to force his way.
Come to drop his relatives.
So he cannot enter the area.
No. He was neither traveling by the flight.
He cannot enter.
Or did he come to drop his relatives?
Well, I think I hope this.
He arrived by the incoming. Flight.
Sir, that's he can arrive by any flight. He cannot be in the departure area. He can be in the exit side, but he cannot be in the departure area.
There is a growing view. One sec. The reason this question is being asked is, you see, Mr. Rangarao, listen to me. Mr. Rangarao, the problem is this. In this feudal,
Mr. Rangarao,
yeah.
You know so much detail that he was not there, he arrived, but you don't know the detail that he was beaten up. You don't know the detail that there is CCTV footage, but you know every detail of your man, whatever nonsense he has told you. You're sir, trying to cover up, and I can tell you, you'll have a slap on your face when the charge is put on you.
You don't need the footage. You have this flimsy ground that the MP has given himself a clean chit. I mean, the case is strong enough. It's a case of suo motu action by either the Civil Aviation Minister or, as Saravanan rightly says, the courts.
No, Arnab.
Yes, I'm wrapping up. I'm short of time.
Have you spoken to CISF? Have you spoken to the person?
The pictures of the MP on your screen tonight.
What nonsense is that?
The pictures of the MP on your screen tonight. Viewers, the pictures of this MP on your screen tonight. This is the man who has roughed up and slapped an Air India station manager. The government so far has done absolutely nothing. It is unfortunate that we allow this man to flaunt his so-called political clout and get away with it. I thank you all for joining me on debate number 2 on the News Hour tonight. Thank you. We're tracking the story.